Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. So today we are going to give a brief introduction about research methodology and intellectual property rights. So we'll discuss, before we start the syllabus, we will discuss the syllabus first. And here this particular subject is there for fifth semester, and every fifth semester under VTU it's compulsory, and the course code is 21 RMI 56. So research methodology RM, and we are having IPR, that is intellectual property rights, as I 56. This is the sixth subject of your fifth sem. So we are having internal as 50 and external as 50. It's the same thing what we have done, and it has got maybe two credits, okay, 100 marks exam and three things. Okay, we are having the CO1, CO2, CO3 and CO4. CO1 is to understand the knowledge on basis of research and its types. That means how many, what exactly is the meaning of research, and why do we have to study research in engineering, or engineer, why do we need, as engineering students, why do we have to get exposed to the research in order to get best out of our particular fields, or the current trend, how exactly it's going, and all other stuff on in future, how our particular field is going and in what direction it is going. Okay, so in order to understand that, we need to have the basic idea about what is research. So your CO1 first is to understand the knowledge on basis of the research and its type. And then we are having CO2 is nothing but to learn the concepts of literature review. For example, the concepts are there, something called research literature review or review of literature. And how do we have to do that? Because in your in your minor projects, like in your third year, okay, we are having a mini project, and we are having the major project, which is your final engineering project. In both the projects, you need, there is something called literature of review or review of literature. Okay, so this review of literature has to happen in order to proceed for your research, okay, or projects. In your projects, there has to be one chapter called review of literature. Okay, so I will tell you why, what you mean by review of literature, that later. Okay, so that was about a CO2 and CO3. CO3 is to learn the ethics in engineering research. So also we need to know that we not only just research, and not only what the research can add on to our field, but also we should aware about the ethical issues. For example, the ethics which is involved in the particular conduction of the result, whether it is safe for the humanity, whether it is safe for the animals, whether it is safe for the, you know, the ecosystem, all other things, the ethical issues we need to study, and in order to get the best or practices, in order to get wonderful results, without you know, with the all ethical aspects concerned, like safety, you know, all other issues, safety, it can be the safety, it can be the, you know, non-toxic, or it can be any kind of things where which is not harmful. We are going to conclude that this particular research is not going to harm anyone. So that kind of things will be there. So those all things comes under ethical concerns or ethical issues in research. And then we are having the fourth CO, that is to discuss the concepts of IPR. So concepts of IPR, when you speak about, it's about the intellectual property rights in engineering. So here in this CO, what it says is that here in this particular subject, you will be exposed, or you will go learn what are IPR, I mean what exactly IPR stands for, that is intellectual property rights, and why we need IPR, and why the property rights are important, why the copyrights are important. All those things we are going to study in this course, particularly in this syllabus. Okay, next we are having the teaching learning process. The general instructions are there, which is given here. I don't have to just explain this, these things already you know. The lecturers should be knowing lecture methods, use of video to explain all other stuff and all. Let's jump to the syllabus, that is the introduction.
So in introduction, we will be speaking about the meaning of research. So what is the meaning? What do you mean by research? As the name itself, today I'll give you the brief introduction about your particular syllabus. Okay. From tomorrow or the next video onwards, we will have the proper session or proper explanation about all these things. So meaning of research. Research stands for research. Okay. There is something already is existing, but I want to research. That means I have prepared something. Okay, now I have to incorporate some properties extra to this, so that how it is this particular device is going to function. So whether it is going to function as the same or whether it is improvising. So to do this analysis itself is called as research. Because you are researching the opportunities, what betterment I can do, what the best thing I can give. That is itself, the whole process is nothing but research. And for example, iPhone 5, there is a big difference between iPhone 5S and iPhone 13 Pro or 14 Pro. The reason is that because of lot of research, okay, these most of the things I keep on adding. Okay, lot of the things, though there are no much difference between 13 and 14 or 14 or 15, but I'm giving an example, a set of example, where we were when we were having the 16 GB phone, right? That is iPhone 5S, and maximum we used to get for 65 or 100, this thing we used to 64, we used to get more exalted. Nowadays 128 GB, even 256 GB, even 1 TB also we are having. Right, 512 and 1 TB we are having. These all are possible only because of the research, not just because of some companies they were existing there, that's why they are doing this. No, they are having, every company is having R&D, that is research and development, and in that particular research and development we have got this particular team which will be looking for something new, to always something new to add on to the particular properties and something to make it better and beneficent. So that's what is research means. So if it is this is how exactly an engineering student should understand as a research, because the research is required in order to go for future. Without research there is no future. Okay, for example, whatever we are having now, for example the classes we are taking by the projectors, okay, that is also a product of the research, or else we have to do only chalk and board, understanding. And nowadays everybody is using cell phones, right? Earlier it was only landlines or coin box. Whenever you wanted to talk, you have to search outside where exactly the coin boxes are there, then you have to make a call. Okay, and even though when you are traveling, you have to get down, you have to take tickets only till there and to get down and then make a call and then get another bus. See, this is all over in the, you know, the challenges what we have faced when we were in childhood. Nowadays those challenges are not there in terms of them talking about only telecommunications. So now we can, because of the research only, we were able to have every person is having in the room is having cell phone now. The reason is very simple, it's a product of research. So without research there is no future. If any country has to go for future, it has to invest lot of its resources and money and capital, everything into research. The country will be more grown, the country's development will be more if they are doing research more. And you can take an example of many countries, including Germany, including European countries, including Japan also. Okay, so Japan, you know that after Hiroshima and Nagasaki how much it suffered, yet it stands in top 3 or top 4, you know, this economic countries. The reason is they are strong in research. Anything that the new technology is coming, they are adapting quickly. Their industries are adapting quickly. They are bringing the products so quickly to the market so that the people start using it. So they will get money out of it. So they are very quick in converting the research into the product. Okay, so that's how the research works. That's the meaning of research. Then we are having objectives of engineering research. So what are the objectives of the engineering research that we are going to study? Okay, how exactly this particular, you know, the what are the goals of the engineering research? It can be the ethical issues, and it can be the to reduce the global warming, or it can be to have the better efficient batteries, better efficient fuel cells, or it can be the better more eco-friendly vehicles, or all these things comes under, you know, objectives of engineering research, where lot of researchers are going on already. And then motivation in engineering. Okay, so that is motivation in engineering research is very important, because without the motivation nothing is going to work. So research has to happen in order to have research, because research is boring. The reason is very simple, because it takes lot of trials. You need to have around 100 to 500 types of, you know, times experiments you have to do, then you will get the optimum results, then only you are going to get the product. That's why it's bit a tedious job, and the lazy people will not like the research. But if you really get into the research, it's a wonderful field, because research is the only thing which can be a future. Okay, and wonderful things can be done with the research, and types of the engineering research that we will also will be studying, and then finding and solving worthwhile problem or worldwide problem, all those things we will be discussing. Next, ethical issues, like ethics in engineering research, what ethics need to be maintained, what are the values, or fundamental rules and laws we need to stick on to, so that in order to get the particular research being done, okay, which should not go out of any boundaries or beyond any, you know, what do you say, the sentiments of the people or humans, or even the it should not be so cruel to the animals also when you are doing research. Okay, there are a lot of preclinical studies and all we will be doing based on biomedical and biotechnological aspects, and clinical research and preclinical research. So all those things need to be taken care, and when you are using the humans for testing some new drugs and all, for that also we need to take care of the ethical issues. So all ethical concerned things we will be discussing. Then types of research misconduct. A lot of times the research will be misconduct. That means the people will misconduct the research. How it may be, for example, you might have heard about this particular corona came because of the something is leaked from some laboratory. All rumors you might have heard, or maybe you might have heard the China is making a lot of weapons, that this and all, or some country, some X country, some Y country, some Z country, they are making so many things, that which is going to end the world, that these kind of research. I mean, all these things, rumors you might have heard. These all rumors or whatever you have seen, imagine whether they are real or not, but here in our example consider it as a real, and then all those things will come under research misconduct. Then ethical issues related to the authorships. For example, I write a paper, I publish, and somebody else will claim that particular thing, and he copies from my paper, the image he copies and he publishes in his paper, then that will be a copyright breach. Copyright breach. So same thing goes for the ethical issues. The ethical issues related to the authorships also has to be maintained. If somebody is doing its original work, that has to be maintained and preserved by the publishers, so that they have to, so that they can be relied on or trusted on. And then we are having the module 2, that is about module 1. Module 2 we are having literature review and technical reading. So literature review and technical reading is very important. What is the literature review or review of literature is that, see, imagine I want to build a product A. Imagine I want to build this product. Now I have to see whether this product is there in the whole market or not. Okay, in research I'm talking about, not in commercialization, not in business. Okay, this product, this particular drug or this particular product, whether it is there in the market right now or not, you have to check that. So new and existing knowledge should be there. Okay, So analysis and synthesis of prior art biographical databases you should understand. So that means I have to go and check in the particular databases where the research has been getting published. For example, maybe Web of Science, Google Scholar, or just a Google, or all these things. These are all things, databases, bibliography, you will get all the published data. Every day there will be hundreds of thousands of papers will be published, and all the papers will be monitor, or you can say the stored in this particular publishers. So in Google Scholar or Web of Science, or even having bibliography databases, different databases, you can go to there, you can Scopus, or you can just go to them, then you can try, see this particular product, if the product A I want to produce, I have the product A, I am writing there. If nothing is coming, if no papers are there in this particular which worked on the product A, then your work or the idea is very new. Okay, so imagine if it is not new. Okay, so then what you have to do, you have to see whatever the existing things are there, you have to read all those papers, you have to come to note in the conclusion that these things are there in this particular product, but whatever I want to do is something different from whatever already existing things are there. So something new is there from my end, but the product is same. Something new I am going to add to this particular product and I am going to publish, then only you can publish. So this is reviewing. Okay, you have to see if any publications are there or if any work has been done on this particular field, see comparing all those field, this thing, and also see what is your idea. If your idea is something which is new than the already existing data or papers in all these databases, then we can say that your work, you can continue that work. Or else if you continue the work without doing a review of literature, you will end up developing a product which is already being done by someone in America, someone in UK, someone in Japan, or something like that. Understanding? So review of literature is must. Without a review of literature, if you are going to study, if you are going to start you are putting money, your effort and your time, all these things will be waste, because a review of literature is the only thing which will tell you that this work is new, whatever you are thinking is new. Okay, because if whatever the idea I have got, the same idea might have got 2 years earlier in some other person might have got the same idea in some other part of the world, so that I cannot go and ask him, right? But he might have published his paper in this particular field or in this particular area where he is doing actually. So that can be, so that he can say there this particular thing has been done. Okay, once that these Web of Science, Google Scholars and all, they are keeping the records of all this data. When I go and see, this work has been done, it is being done, so I don't have to do that same work, I can add some work. So there will be, imagine some particular word I will type, so this particular product related I type, I get hundreds of papers related regarding this. I have to go through all 100 papers. Once I read all 100 papers, I will make sure, I will come to know that which work in this particular part is pending, or what the new ideas you will get, so that what kind of things, changes I should make, I can make to, in order to get a new product or new paper to get published. So that is called as review of literature. You need to see, review the literature which is existing earlier with respect to your idea, so that you don't have to waste your time, energy and your resources. Okay, and after getting that, you'll be having the same thing, and that cannot be published by these particular top quality journals, because they directly reject by saying that your work is already been published. That means this particular work has been published by someone else 2 years back, 3 years back. So in order to avoid this particular thing, we need review of literature. So how to do that, and I will explain in the next class, the very next class I will be explaining that. When I am taking the class for module 2, I will explain all those things. So next, effective research. So the better is the review of literature, you will find, once the literature review is done, you will find something is missing there, that is called as a research gap. If that research gap, if the review is so good, that means if you have studied all these particular existing things in your particular field, whichever, whatever the idea you got, you'll come to know that the something is missing, so that I can work on that and I can improvise and I can get the research done and then I can publish that paper. Okay, then you can say that you will, that will be an effective search, or you can go for effective project. So next, where I'm effective search, the way of the forward introduction of the technical reading, conceptualization research, that is technical reading things, then criteria and creative reading, so that is again same things. Next, taking notes while reading, so that has to be there. You have to, every paper you are writing, reading, because there are 100 papers, example I've given now. So in first paper, paper 1, 2, 3, 4, 100 paper, you name it as 100. So first paper 1, paper 1, how many lines you can read, you can make maximum one paragraph with 4-5 lines. The whole paper, you have to write it in your own words, what you understood in this particular whole paper. Okay, for example, another example, I want to synthesize nanoparticles. So in particular paper, some, they have done lot of this, 20 pages are there. But after reading that, I will write the so-and-so research, Sharif et al. They have done the work on the synthesis of silver nanoparticles from the penicillin species. Okay, they have carried out 4 different antimicrobial test, and they have tested it for 4 different antibiotics, and silver nanoparticles along with the erythromycin gave the best result. That's it. So these 3 lines or 4 lines, your review is done. This is like a taking notes and reading mathematics and algorithms. This income in terms of the students who belong to this particular subjects, where the mathematics and algorithms and data sheets are involved. Okay, reading data sheets, all those things, because this subject is common for all. So next, attributions and citations. Attributions and citations are nothing but, your citation is nothing but, see, I publish work, a particular work. Now you as a person, you will do the review. In that, imagine my paper is also is one of the paper which you are reviewed, and out of 100 papers. Now you review 100 papers. Now you will publish your work, and under your reference there will be 100 papers. In that, one paper is mine. So once you publish your paper, okay, in a reputed journal, Web of Science or Scopus, all those things, so I will be getting how many? One citation. That means somebody has got inspired from my work, and they have taken my work into consideration, and they have used in either discussing or something else in their research, and they have published their research. Then only I get one citation. So that's how the attribution and citation works. I will try to just go forward, and when these things module wise we can explain later. So giving credit wherever due or citations are there, that person is giving credit to me, so I get one citation. So citations, functions and attributes, impact of title, keywords on citations, because all these keywords and things are very important, because if I have whatever the title is there in my this thing, so when you are searching a particular this thing, if there any one of the keyword is matching, 4 or 5 keywords we have to give for every publications, then my paper will be displayed there. Okay, so knowledge of flow through the citation, how exactly the things goes. Next, citation databases, style of citations. There are a lot of style of citations are there. MSA format is there, APA format is there. Okay, a lot of formats are there. So that is depending on the different those who have created it. Maybe, for example, Harvard University, they are having their own format, Harvard format, like that. So everyone will have their own format, but most widely used formats are 4 or 5 formats which is available in Google Scholar. So acknowledgements and attributions, then what should be acknowledged, what exactly should be acknowledged. For example, I have done my project. Okay, I got a project funded by 9 lakhs or something. When I do my work, okay, based on this particular project, I need to acknowledge the funding agency who it has been funded. So in acknowledgement, I will write these are the funders who helped financially to get this research done, or maybe those who helped, for them also we can acknowledge. Maybe the lab attender, it starts from the lab attender to the director or a dean of the institutes, whoever is helping you, or if any sister institutes are helping, if any different institutes like IITs and NITs are helping, wherever you are going for giving your sample for research and this thing, or if any companies are helping in order to do the all these chip check, all those things and all, there also you can acknowledge them in your reports or in your paper. Okay, acknowledgements in books, dissertations, dedication to the acknowledgement, all those things will be there. So next we are having the module 3. Module 3 is about an introductory to IPR, that is about the copyrights, how exactly copyrights happened in India, how XML is originated, what are the laws, all those things we will be discussing. Patent. Patent is different from the publication. Publication is papers and books and all we can publish, whereas patent also can be published, but patent is something which you only own. Okay, no one else can own it. Okay, that is called as patent. For example, the straw what we drink, okay, it was straight earlier, right? So now somebody gave that spring nature and he patented it. So if somebody wants to use, any company wants to manufacture that, he has to take a permission from this guy, so he can charge for them. That is the beauty of patent. Next we are having process of patent, how exactly we are going to choose, how we are going to apply, application process will be there, all those things we will be discussing. Next, copyrights and related things. Copyrights things you already know, because most of the people are exposed to the social media, and nowadays the copyright is very important. Okay, if you are creating any content for your YouTube, you cannot copy from others. So copyright is, the publisher will have copyright, you will be having copyrights. No other can use your original content. If they use, they will be in trouble. You can take action against them. Trademarks are something, if you want to bring some new product to the company or to the market, you will have to register it. Once you register, you can build the trade, you can have a trademark. For example, there are a lot of companies are there, which example for example Bisleri, whatever we drink water, that is also a trademark, understanding? So those kind of applications are there that has to be registered in India. Next, module 5, here we'll be discussing about industrial designs, how the industrial designing takes place, eligibility criteria, how the laws and these acts are, they involve in the to govern industrial designs, and how exactly industrial design should be, the plant should be, all those things will come into picture. Geographical indications also plays a very important acts, maybe laws and rules like pertaining the geographical indications, ownership of the GI, rights which is granted to the holders, registered GI in India, identification of registered GI, all those things we can discuss. Next till GI ecosystem in India. Next, case studies on patents also we can discuss, where we can have the turmeric patent, then neem patent, okay, or basmati patent, and IP organizations in India, schemes and all the programs also we can discuss in module 5. So that's how it is, and that's our syllabus and assessment details. We are having both internal and external, and continuous internal evaluation you are getting the 20 marks, and then 10 marks, and followed by 50 marks. All those things you already know this. So these are the textbooks you can refer. Okay, I'll be referring the same textbooks for your this particular subject, and I'll be preparing PPTs and explaining you some of the things. I'll not prepare PPTs, I'll just go to the Google Scholar and I will explain you how things works. Okay, so that's it. If you have any doubts, you can get back to me.